rock on the track.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to Emerse Podcast 360. I'm your host, Maserati. We want to thank you guys for tuning in. No matter where you are in this metaverse world, we're going to continue to bring you the best quality content and formula that we know how. We want to thank you guys for all the likes, shares, and subscriptions on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, and now TikTok. Hey, all the love is greatly appreciated here at Emerse 360. This is being brought to you by Involve Social and Civic Club, Brazil Family Insurance, and Kick Thrones of Scrap City, Louisiana. And do we have a throwback guest for you guys for Beyond the Game? He is a graduate of the class of 1993. He was an all-district baseball player, and he was an all-district football player as well. He was one of the best to ever do it from his era in the playground, in the sand lot, and on through high school. Hey, we have him in the building, y'all. A true Scrap City baller, an unforgotten legend, I'm going to say. He's with us. Scrap City's own Wade Stevens is in the building. How you doing today, Wade?
Man, I'm doing great. That was fantastic. Thanks for having me.
Oh, man, we greatly appreciate you having you on the show, brother. You are a true Scrap City legend when it comes to Carter Park and Barrascope High football. They can't say that you wasn't a real one out there doing it, brother. And we just glad to have you on to tell your story about the true legacy of Wade Stevens. So how things been going for you, Wade?
Oh, man, great. I'm living down in Baton Rouge now, and married and have a 16-year-old daughter, and I'm just living the dream down here in Baton Rouge.
Right. For the listening audience that may not be familiar with Wade Stevenson, Wade, kind of share with the people about you growing up in Scrap City and the competitive nature we had coming up. Just give people a background about Scrap City and what it means to you.
Oh, man, where do I start? I was born and raised in Bastrop, born in Morehouse General, and grew up there my whole life. Went to grade school and junior high and high school, and man, from a sports perspective, the competition that we had when I was there, it was District 2-5A, which was definitely a powerhouse in the state, and we competed at the highest levels with some of the greatest talent, I really believe, in America at that time when I was in school. So, so when I think of my childhood and growing up in Bastrop, I just smile. It was a great place to grow up and a great place to be, and just a lot of great memories.
Well, we get to talking about you, Wade Stevenson. I always go back to looking at the demographics and how they have changed here in Scrap City. And when we were coming along, it's kind of like, 90% of the community is African-American now. And then we came along, it was 50-50. And having both genders and both ethnic groups kind of gave us a different flavor back then. We look forward to playing against the Wade Stevens, or playing on the same team with the Wade Stevens, the Matt Knights, the Eric Herndon. Kind of take these people on a journey of truly playing Dixie Youth Baseball in Carter Park.
Yeah. So, Carter Park. Wow. I mean, I grew up at Carter Park, from the time I was old enough to walk, playing cup ball out and, not even being on the field, just playing cup ball, watching the older kids. I can remember, Carter Park. It was the place to be, several nights a week, and on the weekends, I mean, that's where we spent our lives. But yeah, Bastrop, at that time we had, the paper mill was there, and we had a definitely different demographics in Bastrop. And, one thing I always appreciated, is that I got to compete, with some of the greatest athletes really, in the state, not just the athletes that we had at Bastrop, but the athletes that we competed against at the district level. So, yeah. It was definitely a great time.
Right. You know, and we always we look at things now here in Scrop City and how things have changed so dramatically. But I look at things back when we were coming along and we were competing. You know, it wasn't a racial divide like it's kind of grew to now. It may have been there, but we didn't notice it because we were truly competing and trying to make each other better. It was man sharpening man, iron sharpening iron, you know. And I kind of share with the people how that competitive nature we had going all the way through looking at Bears Cry being 0-10 and you going on to Bears Cry to be a phenomenal athlete in football. And we still was up for the task knowing we may go 0-10.
Yeah, so, man, you know, not to say that there weren't, you know, racial divisions when we were growing up. I mean, we definitely saw those. But you know, I think we were, I don't know, I like to think we were a little bit different. You know, our classes were one of the first classes that had, you know, an integrated prom. And, you know, we grew up competing hard with each other. You know, when I look back on my life and, you know, one of my, you know, first friends in my life was Gary Green playing baseball on my dad's Dixie Youth baseball team. And, you know, I played and competed with Gary my entire, you know, career growing up all the way through high school. And just when I look back on, you know, gosh, Bob Curlin and his basketball league that he started. You know, I can remember Pat Jones dominating out on the court when we were 8 years old in that league. And, you know, we just, you know, definitely, you know, there were racial differences, but I didn't feel it as much growing up as maybe some of my predecessors because we were more integrated and more, you know, we just had our 30-year reunion for class of 1993. And gosh, the hugs and kisses and just the love that we showed each other there just is a testament to, I guess, how we felt about each other as classmates.
Right. You know, we had Miss Missy Quinn on and Miss Tappan and several others. And, they always refer back to that class, you guys in particular, about the things you was able to accomplish academically and athletically. But kind of share with the people about some of the pastimes that you had exactly at Bastrop High School from an academic standpoint.
From an academic standpoint?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I was fortunate. I got a big dose of Miss Tappan. I got to have her as a teacher for eighth and ninth grade. And then she followed us over, to high school and, man, what a special lady. She just, was an outstanding educator. And then, you know, that was one of the greatest things, I guess, about growing up at Bastrop is that we had some of the best teachers, I think, really looking back, you know, and you know, my daughter, you know, goes to a private school down here in Baton Rouge. And I look at the teachers that I had growing up in Bastrop and they were phenomenal. And I would put them up against anybody that I see today in the private school system here where I live. It was just a phenomenal group of people. You know, Mitzi Quinn, I mean, she's a legend. Everybody, you know, Zach was her son and one of my best friends. And I pretty much grew up at her house and she loved us all like we were her own children, you know. And but there were several great educators that we had. And, you know, Miss White, Miss Heckford, you know, I look back on high school, you know, we had a great education. And for myself, from where I sit today in my life, you know, I'm very fortunate that I was able to get the level of education that I got at Bastrop and very proud of it, quite frankly.
And most definitely, and it always speak highly of you when they spoke about the class of 1993 and even through the 90s. You know, you guys were inspirational to us coming along as freshmen. We're looking forward to being on the gridiron and being on the diamond with you guys. But Wade, we're going to take an intermission, and when we come back, we're going to visit some more and reminisce about your days playing linebacker at Basketball High, and then we're going to introduce these people to what the true sport was when we was coming along. It made you a real baller, and that's out there on that diamond. We're going to be right back with the legendary baller from Scrop City himself, Mr. Wade Stevens, when we return after this intermission. Welcome back. This portion of the show is being brought to you by Stepping Stones LLC of Jonesboro, Louisiana, and your community newspaper, Scrop City Community Voice Newspaper. We want to thank you guys for all the support out there. We're still here with Scrop City baller, street legend, baseball legend when it comes to doing what it do on the playground. We're still here with Wade Stevenson reminiscing about the Scrop City Basketball High School days. Wade, kind of take us back to your days playing up under old Rick Hudson at Basketball High School at linebacker.
Yeah, man. So I played linebacker my senior year. Back in the days, you know, most of us played both ways. So, when Talan Sawyer was the phenom tight end my senior year, but we would go to a two tight end set every now and then, and I would come out and play tight end on the other side. But yeah, linebacker was my position. And, when I look back on my career, you know, I think we were 5-5 my senior year. We took Ouachita at that time, who was one of the powerhouses in the state. They had Jamie Spencer, who signed with Notre Dame. We took them to double overtime in our last game of the year, you know, and just a lot of great memories. I mean, we were in District 2-5A, you know, Neville, Ouachita, Ruston, just a powerhouse district. And, I think we competed pretty well. You know, we at that time, we certainly didn't have the state championship caliber teams that we grew accustomed to later at Bastrop, you know, which I was very proud of. But I like to think that, we were one of the classes that kind of started it all, you know, as in respect to, winning, we won five games, which at that time was a big accomplishment for us at Bastrop.
Right, Bastrop was
not winning a lot of games during that period, you know, so for us to come in and win five games in football was kind of a big deal at that point, especially in the district that we competed in, you know, and one thing I'm very proud of is that, you know, we competed in every game. We were not blown out by anybody. We went out and they knew that they played the Bastrop Rams whenever they played us.
Right, Wade, and brother, that's why I wanted to have you. I wanted to get it from a different perspective. Like I say, the demographic has changed, but I wanted to hear it from a legend that meant something to me, that they don't look like me, don't come from where I come from. You know, I just want people to know and hear for themselves the competitive nature we had with Delta, with Prairie View in existence. It wasn't a bickering. We was proud for everybody. And Wade Stevens is here to prove that. We was focused on just winning football games. We didn't care about the politics and what was going on with the grown folks. We was focused on changing the culture at Bastrop High School. And this is one of the guys that helped do it with the class of 1993. Wade, who are some of the guys that that was particular inspirational to you during those days?
Oh man, we from a football side, my side was defense, so I kind of start there. We had Carl Givens, who was a strong safety. He was really he was one of the captains of the team from a motivational standpoint. That really kept us all energized and motivated, and then side by side with me on linebacker, Eric Hernan, one of my best friends, who's now the strength coach at Neville. I picked at him not too long ago that he's in better shape now than he was when we played at high school.
I think that's true with all of us, bro.
Yeah. But, man, we had some hosses at Bastrop High School, Terrence Moses, golly, that guy, Matt Knight, one of the meanest guys I ever played against, Matt Knight, Jason Fitch, Paul Shaw, and then we go to the offense side of the ball where we had, what I call our phenom. You had Fred Hawson at quarterback, who I think you interviewed not too long ago, just a phenomenal athlete, not only in football, but also in baseball. To Lance Sawyer, I mean, we all know what he accomplished. My goodness, Marcus Sawyer. I look at some of the people that we played against or played with, and the biggest thing that we had, we had the athletes at Bastrop High School. When I talk about all those people from a football standpoint, I was probably the worst athlete out of everybody I just named. We had some phenomenal athletes at Bastrop High School. The biggest thing that we were missing was just discipline, And I heard your interview with Brad Bradshaw, and I think that's one of the things that made him so successful when he came to Bastrop is the discipline that he brought to the program. But, we had great coaches and we had, great athletes, but we really didn't know how to win. We had to will ourselves to win. And that's one of the things that I'm most proud of is that, once we won a game and we really saw what that was like and, felt that feeling of winning, it really showed us all that we had more in us than we really knew. And I think that's what was probably missing a lot at Bastrop High School is just knowing that we had the capability of doing it and the discipline that was needed day in and day out to be a winner. If we would have had a little bit more discipline, I think in our class, there's no doubt in my mind, we would have been a district champion and definitely a playoff contender.
Right. And it's like I say, this guy here was a two-star athlete. He was nasty himself on that football field. He just being modest out here, y'all. But he was a mean joker out there, too. Like, he named some guys, Eric Herndon, Carl Givens, Ohizo Causes. We called him the human highlight.
Oh, man, Hizo. I'm going to tell you something about Hizo. I was playing defense with Hizo one time. And he caught an interception, and I was blocking for him. And I turned around and looked, and he was 20 yards down the field past me already. He was so fast, and he had great hands. And, man, Hizo was an outstanding athlete, just probably one of the best hands people we had on our team. He could really catch the ball.
Right. Like you say, you testifying, Wade, to an argument I have. And it's nothing against the state championship teams, but it was 4A football. The people that we played against, the names are still talked about in various sports blogs, your Jameis Spencers, your Rondell Mealy's, and the list goes on, the guys that we played against coming up. And it was 5A football at the time. We had our own commercial. We had two guys that had their own commercial. And the thing about it is, if people will, if I don't, we don't share the story with what we're doing today, people forget about the trendsetters, the ones who set the foundation. Even I give homage to the ones before us, but you guys changed the culture at Bastrop High School in so many ways. But let's jump over into the next sport that really separated the men from the boys, and people don't believe it. If you didn't play baseball during the 80s and the 90s, we didn't consider you an athlete unless you just was a phenom in your sport. But if you played baseball, we considered you to be a true baller during those days. Wade, share it with them.
Oh, man. You're humbling me now. You know, baseball was something that I played from an early age. I mean, I played football too, but baseball was just something that just always came more natural to me. You know, and my dad coached me all the way through almost until, I guess, until I got in high school. He coached a lot of other people in Bastrop, and, you know, really – I owe everything that I have in, you know, my love for the game and my respect for the game really to my father, who was always present at practice and just, you know, and really teaching the game. And I guess the irony of that is that he wasn't a baseball player when he was growing up, you know, but he decided to get involved at an early age, and my brother played baseball, and he started coaching, and just really developed a love of the game for me. And, you know, like I said, I grew up at Carter Park, dragging an old bat around the playground, playing cut ball, watching all the older kids. That's where I grew up, and I fell in love with it. And, man, you know, just last year, I had the opportunity to take my father to see LSU play in the World Series in Omaha, and it was a bucket list kind of thing for us because I just reminisced the whole time about the time that my father put in teaching me the game and teaching others the game and really showing us a love for the game and the strategy behind the game. You know, a lot of people don't realize, you know, how much strategy there is in the game of baseball. But, you know, we were learning how to bunt and steal bases. I can remember having sliding practice when I was 10 years old and nobody else was doing that. You know, you would just show up and you would hit and throw, but my dad had us out there fundamentals, and we would even practice sliding, and nobody was practicing sliding back in those days, you know? But yeah, I mean, I was fortunate. I had some ability in baseball. When I look back on, you know, what I was able to accomplish, you know, I was a pretty good hitter. I had a decent arm, and I played with a lot of great athletes. A lot. Bastrop, Louisiana has produced some of the greatest baseball athletes. And a lot of people don't realize that. And I really appreciate your show because you've highlighted some of these great athletes that we've had in Bastrop from a baseball standpoint. I mean, you look back at some of the people that we've had come through Bastrop, you know, just Bastrop in general, that have been phenomenal baseball players. It really is amazing.
Right. Most definitely. And you know, this guy, he's still being modest, but he could swing that stick. He was batting average round bat, I will say, about 400 at one time during his high school career. And the only person to do that, we know for a fact, broke that record was Justin Kennedy, who went on to play for the Philadelphia Phillies. But Wade Stevens, I'm going to keep telling you guys, when we were coming up, and they're older than me, this guy's name, when it came to football and baseball, stayed in the mix for up to 15 years, right along with the Roy Lee Jacksons, who we already had on the show, as he said, the Fred Halstons and the Michael Williams. His name was relevant in baseball. Tyrone Morgan, Eric Herndon, like these guys, Matt Knight, the guys that he named that played football. We played baseball. We play baseball, two people. I'm so glad to have another person from a different demographic to finally get on Emerge 360 and testify to you people so you'll get off this bandwagon about what the true meaning of an athlete is. Wade, we're going to take another intermission, and we're going to finish and wrap up with you, but we're going to reminisce for a little while longer and get your closing statements on what would you like to share with the city of Bastrop and what would you like to see us going for. We'll be right back with the legendary baseballer and hard hitter, true knocking heads off, Wade Stevens, when we return. Welcome back to the show. We're still here with legendary baller on the diamond and hard hitter on the football field, Wade Stevenson himself, class of 1993, the ones that put Bastrop on the track that we're trying to regain. Wade, before we let you go, man, you're being modest here, and you've been very modest. But honestly, from the mouth of Wade Stevenson, where do you see Bastrop all time when it comes to being one of the outstanding programs in Northeast Louisiana?
Man, I'm very proud of Bastrop. You know, obviously, when we were in high school, our baseball team made it to the state semifinals, you know, and that was a huge accomplishment at that time. It was the 1990 team, you know. We had folks like Jimmy Turner on that team, who was just probably one of the best all-around athletes I've ever seen in my life, you know. But outside of that, you know, our track team was phenomenal. You know, Coach Gary Hines and Clyde Lloyd, they had a phenomenal track team. But outside of that, we didn't have a lot of accolades, you know, from other sports. But yeah, so I'm very, very proud of what the city accomplished after I left. You know, the state championships on the football side, I'm so proud of that. And but I'm extremely proud of you know, what we were able to accomplish, even though we may not have won a lot of championships and what have you. You know, I think we set a tone of competition, and we gave people hope that I can remember after I left. You know, Fred Hawson was quarterbacking the team after I graduated, you know, and they were competing on a high level. And we were just so excited about that, about us having the opportunity to, you know, and change, I guess, change the mind shift, change the culture of, you know, thinking about Bastrop in a winning fashion. Versus losing, which there was, you know, so just 0-10 and not being able to compete at the highest level. So, you know, when I look back, I'm proud of what we did, but I'm also extremely proud to be from Bastrop and the folks that came after us that won the championships. I mean, the big names that came through that just set the world on fire. I'm so proud of those guys, and it makes me very proud to be able to tell people that I'm from Bastrop. I grew up in Bastrop. I'm proud to be from Bastrop, and you know, Bastrop can win. Bastrop be a winner, right?
Most definitely. You know, and you know, Wade, if you could go back to the 18-year-old Wade Stevenson, what would you tell him?
Well, you know, I think about that. You know, one of the things, you know, my mom started me in school too early. So when I started my year of high school at Bastrop High School, I was 16 years old. And I played my senior year of football at Bastrop High School at 16 years old. and I graduated at 17. So, you know, by today's standards, that's really young. Folks are not doing that much these days. They're getting held back and what have you, and they're older when they graduate. So when I was 18, I was deep into my year of college. And, you know, at that point in time, I had, you know, parties and women on my mind and trying to hurry up and get out of school. But if I could go back to 18 and really look at myself in the face and tell myself, you know, to take a different path or to do something differently, I would say that embrace the struggle. You know, everybody today is trying to take the easy way out and live an easy life, but really it's in the struggle that makes you better. And whether that be, you know, you're working out, trying to be an athlete, whether you're trying to study hard to get a degree and get a good job, it's in the struggle that makes you better. And embrace it. You know, enjoy the struggle, because it's in the struggle that we all get better. And 18-year-old self was trying to not necessarily embrace the struggle, but I was probably trying to find the easier out. And, you know, the older I get, I realize that that's what makes us better, you know, overcoming and really digging in deep and really embracing the hard things in life we have to do that makes us better.
Right. You know, in way, you just gave a heartwarming closure. I don't think we can ever close it out any better than that, you know. And I want to thank you for taking out the opportunity to come and be on Beyond the Game and give a different perspective. And man, to stop, and I finally get a chance to stop looking like I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? That was a good feeling to have another testimony. Real, I'm talking about for real, brother. I really appreciate you. Before one last thing, what would you like to share with the people from Scribe City, from Wade Stevens?
Well, I would just like the people from Bastrop to know that I have a lot of love for the city. I'm very proud to be from Bastrop. You know, I joke around and I tell people if I ever win the lottery, I'm giving a lot of money at Bastrop High School. You know, there's love for where I grew up, the people that I grew up with. You know, and I know that we've all gotten older and some of us have moved out and moved on. But when we look back on our childhood and the people that we grew up with and the city that we grew up in, you know, most of us, and I don't think, you know, for most people, we really love Bastrop and everything about Bastrop, and we want Bastrop to be successful, and we want our school to flourish, and we want our athletes to win, and we, you know, we really are proud of where we came from, and I really sincerely want everyone to know that.
Right, Wade. Once again, brother, we appreciate you for stopping through and sharing those moments and reminiscing and giving us a brief history lesson what it means to Wade Stevens in the class of 1993. But guys, I know you was like, oh, he did all that. What was his scholarship offer? Well, I'm going to leave you with this. He turned that down to go after academics. I'm your host, Maserati. This has been Wade Stevens, Scrop City legend when it comes to football and playing baseball. Hey, y'all stay tuned. It's more to come. Y'all get involved. Y'all get encouraged. And most of all, y'all stay immersed. We out of this thing.
Yeah, this is the real Ross, and I'm going to give a shout out to my nephew, Kick Dirty. Positive journey. Everybody stand up for positivity.
All my big dogs, won't you stand up? All my street dudes, won't you stand up? If you white collar, give me stand up. If you get it in the penny, stand up. Now all my big boss chicks, stand up. Now all my keep it good chicks, stand up. Now if you get it how you live, stand up. Nice whip on crib, stand up. I keep my fist in the air, cause I don't care. Look hard until I die, I'ma try to get you up out of there. Most high, watch out for it, cause big bro in these streets. I share my life
when I talk behind these beats. Yeah. A 318 rider, standing on top of the South. It's your boy PJ. I told you what that blue life all about. Still let it focus. I had to finish and let the sun hit it from the city. Full of hustles, born and raised, go get it. Stop to the hustler, stay connected to the muscle. It's red, black, and green over here, way deeper than colors. Mama said, son, go hard, don't look back. Lead a past where it's at, always state these facts. Truth be told, kinfolk, we living in the last days. Government shutdowns, and yeah, ain't nobody getting paid. That's why I'm dying to stay focused, my enemies necessary. Cause there's too many of mine buried early in the cemetery. Protect your kids, grind hard, marinate your mind. It's a war going on, and we running out of time. And 92% of the homicides is black on black.